So what do we know about Pat? She's wearing that she's a successful person. Is she relatable to my entire audience if I leave it at that? Do you think most people I talk to are wealthy? No. Most of the population isn't wealthy. So if I left it at that, she's not relatable. Where does she become relatable? Okay, let's dig deeper. She talked to him, but didn't know what she, how is she feeling?
Insecure.
Insecure, scared, not sleeping. Can you relate to that? You ever had to give a presentation and felt sick to your stomach? Now she's relatable. Take away the outer look, you know, the look of her, and now she's just like the rest of us. And that's exactly how she was. She was stressed to the max. So now we've got a relatable character who's in a circumstance which we can all also relate to. So we've got a circumstance and a character, and the third C is conflict. There is no story without a good conflict. Now in traditional storytelling, there are many types of conflict. We don't have time to get into those, and they're not really relevant to business storytelling. I'm not talking about Indiana Jones running from the boulder type conflict, or the conflict in the greatest movie ever made, Star Wars. Yes. It's not Luke versus Darth Vader, you know, with his daddy issue. This is, the greatest conflict is person versus him or herself. Sometimes you can have a person versus person, but the greatest conflict we have is internal, right? Wasn't that Patty's issue? I'm so scared, I'm nervous, I don't want to mess this up. I could destroy our foundation's reputation, I don't want to do that. That's all internal. Do you deal with internal struggles in some area of your life? Every day. You're not human if you don't. So, got to have good conflict, and the conflict also has to escalate in a story. We call this the Titanic effect. Think about the movie Titanic. Just raise your hand if you haven't seen Titanic. That's the first time I think I've ever had a group. So I'm not going to do any spoilers here. But I always figure it's 20 years old. If you haven't seen it by now, I don't think you're rushing out tonight to watch it. So if you haven't seen it, sorry. What do we know about Titanic walking into the theater?
It sinks.
Unless we're going to see something in revisionist history, it is going down. Why did we spend our money in 3 hours and 20 minutes of our life watching a movie when we knew the ending?
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Every time I hear Leonardo DiCaprio. I didn't think Kate Winslet was too bad myself. What was it about the movie, though? It was all of the conflict that was going on. In the beginning, we see this elderly woman on this ship, and then she takes us back in time. This is actually a timeline story. And what do we know about Rose? She's engaged, she's in a family, she's gonna marry into wealth, and she's miserable. And then we meet Leo, right? Leo's the guy who's struggling, not doing too well. But he gambles his way onto a ship. He's having struggles. And we're introduced to all these characters who are having these various struggles. And what happens with these conflicts? They begin to get worse as the movie goes on, right? Here's where James Cameron was brilliant. He's a brilliant storyteller. The Titanic itself, the ship, served as a metaphor for all of the conflict the people were going through. Ship hits the iceberg, water starts to come in. You see it starting to fill up in the lower levels. Then he goes back to some of the conflict. Maybe it's Jack and the people trying to arrest him, the people that arrest him, or Rose and dealing with her family. We go back, the water's coming up higher and higher in the ship. Go back to the conflict, it's escalating. It's back and forth until the very end. When Leo sinks. Bottom of the ocean. Who cares what happens after? There was room for him on that raft. See, 20 years later, we still have some people who are distraught about it. But my point is, the conflict escalated until there was resolution.